a little press on that. Madali ka magalit. Madali mo mapikon. A little press on that. Madali mo naman magtampo. A little press on that. Hello?
Amen!
Buti na lang, hindi si pastor. Kundi ang Lord ang pumupo sa atin. Because God knows those buttons. Alam niya, kapag pinindot ka rito, nagre-react ka. Alam niya yun. Kaya, siya na lang ang pipindot niya. Let me shape you. This is good. And like we have here, then it says there, He personally used His hand in molding you. And then, He has a dysplasia. Alam mo, isang bahay, siyempre, pagpasok niyo sa living room, ilalagay niyo roon yung the best ninyo. Mga expensive furniture. Yung expensive na ano ninyo, na pedestal and everything. Could it be possible that in the house of God, yung mga the best ay ilalagay niya doon sa kanyang showroom? Diba, halimbawa, pumasok ka ng store sa showroom ng isang mga furniture. Lahat ng the best product nila ay nandoon. Sa kanyang simbahan, sa kanyang bahay. So, ilalagay niya yung mga kanya talagang primera de klase sa kanyang showroom. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
And then He will build this person, He will build this person, mga abilities and everything. Praise be to God. Kaya makikita natin na ang bahay ng Diyos, although may mga mess, although may mga differences, although mayroong mga disagreement, although mayroong, alam nyo, pagka isang paso ay basag. Diba makikita mo lahat ng mga pieces? Parang bagang ano yung lahat gamit eh. But in the eyes of God, or in the minds of God, He knows what to do. Sabi ko nga eh, ang lahat ng mga manggagawa ng Diyos, may mga flaws yan eh. We all have flaws. But do not allow those flaws to stop your destiny.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
That's true. And God is allowing those things for our maturity. So that our character will be molded according to Him. By the time that you already train with those kind of differences, let's say, different attitude or different characters, and now you are ready to be used by the Lord. And by the time that God is about to use you, you're already exposed in many kinds of problems and situations.
Amen.
I hope you know what I'm talking about. Hello?
Amen.
God will not put you in the arena if we are not yet ready. The reason why that we are facing some issues, some situation in life, so that God is being, you are being trained by the Lord. You are being exposed in those kind of arena. So by the time you are used, you will be used by the Lord, then you are ready now. Sasabihin mo, ah, galing na ako yan.
Amen.
Oh, naintindihan ko na yan.
Amen.
Oh, sanay na ako dyan. Dumaan na ako doon sa tinatawag na will. Dumaan na ako doon sa proseso. Galing na ako yan. Hindi na ako babalik dyan.
Amen.
Alam mo, kapatid, ito ang experience ko sa'yo. This is my experience and let me share this to you. The reason why I overcame this. So now you're becoming an effective counselor. Because you've been there.
Amen. Lord, amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Kung iiwasan mo yan, hindi ka magiging effective counselor.
Amen.
Just imagine now, Let's say, dito pala sa New York, ilang kayang pamilya ang may mga issue, problema? Marriage about para mag-separate. Mga anak, rebellion, ang problema. And then, now you have to expose. God is allowing to expose on that area. So now, the Lord is preparing you, training you, He's allowing you to be in that process, so by the time that He will use you, then you will say, alam mo kapatid, galing ko yan. Hindi ako iniwanan ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Kapatid, sumama ka sa akin. Sa church, sumama ka sa akin. Sa life group, sumama ka sa akin. Then, in that way, then our brother and sister, then they will learn, well, it's all about Him. Listen to this. Tayo gusto natin lagi komportable. But you know what? Sa Lord, He's after for our character. Kaya nga, ang mga disciple, God's allowing the disciple to experience the storm. God allows Jairus na mamatayan siya ng anak. Jesus allows that. God allows even the apostle to experience yung mga problema, and even Paul the apostle, He allowed Paul the apostle to experience shipwreck. Bakit? Not to destroy you. Not to destroy us. God allowed those things to happen in our lives so that we can be continually ready for issues. Pagdating sa proseso, minsan, dito tayo nasusubukan. And I pray to God that in this process, we can able to sustain, we can able to receive the process. Now, let's see how the potter do. Okay? The vessel. Let's go to the next one. Lesson from the clay. Okay? The very first one. It can only be molded by water. So, in order for a potter to mold the clay, He has to add water on it. Habang minumod dyan, kailangan ng tubig. And do you happen to know, sa atin, while God is molding us, what is that water that we need? God's Word. The Word of God. So, that is our water in order for us to be more pliable. A person who is not hearing God's Word, I'm telling you, that person is very, very stubborn. Kahit anong paliwanag mo, pero hindi niya, wala siyang respeto sa Word of God, useless. So now, what God is using, which is the very Word of God, in order to mold us. Kasi wala namang ibang measurement. The only parameter or measurement is the Word of God. That is our parameter. That is our guideline, the Word of God. If we want to be pliable, soft, then we need to add water in this vessel, the very Word of God. I remember in the book of Genesis, when the way how God, you know, formed Adam and Eve. Diba? Nung si Eva ang ginawa niya, actually si Eva, nainan natin si Eva, bago si Adan. Napansin niyo nung si Eva, ginawa niya ang sabi ng Bible. And God formed the woman. Diba? God formed the woman. Pero nung ginawa niya si Adan, iba. And God, sabi ron? And God even shaped, squeezed the man.
Oh.
Talaga. But when God made Eve, God shaped. Iba yung paraan niya. Nakikita mo. Could it be possible sa mga lalaki, medyo konting kailangan ng pisila? Lalaki yan eh. But the point here, we have to understand God uses water, the very word of God, to shape us. Kasi yung ating upbringing, you have to understand, all our upbringings, you know, they are different. When me and my wife got married, ang dami-dami adjustment. Laking Tondo, laking Quezon City. Ugali ko, ugali. It's nothing wrong being in Tondo. Pero, it's a really a big adjustment. So ngayon, for us to live in harmony, we make the Word of God as our final authority in the house. It's not because that you are Ilocano. It's not because that I am a Bisaya. Maghahon is Bisaya. Okay? It's not about that. It's not about our culture. It's about the Word of God.
Amen.
Yet, when the Word of God is our final authority in the house or in the church, madali mag-submit. Praise the Lord. Hello?
Amen.
So, that's the first one. So, sabi rito sa second one, has to be separated before molding. So easy, we can see here Mark chapter 7 verse 15, it's not what goes into your body that defies or defiles you. You are defiled by what comes from your heart. So here we can see God has to separate those mga illegal elements in our lives. As Christians, God is removing those things, unforgiveness, no mercy, you know, jealousy, or let's say strife or bitterness. God is removing those. God is separating those things. And sometimes, you know, when God is doing that, it's really, really painful.
Yes.
But we have to receive the process.
Amen.
Minsan, the process is very, very personal. Sometimes you allow God to wound you. It's like a surgeon or it's like a doctor. Sometimes the doctor needs to cut you. It's painful. And yet, you have to see that at the end of that, it's for our healing and transformation. It's good. God will remove sometimes mga jealousy niya. Minsan may mararamdaman siya habang during, you know, during the making of the bath. Minsan may mararamdaman siya. May konting bubol dito. Ano ba ito? Hindi tera ka pa. Konting bubol dito. Wala pa ng bata. Right? And sometimes it requires some squeezing. Right? He has to press in order for you to be in good shape. It's so amazing. When God is ready to use someone in the ministry, even the very personal, will be touched by the Lord.